So you tried to make a slider with percents, but it didn't work. Well, it's not you, it's Excel. The issue is the control inputs only accept whole numbers. This means we need to be a little creative to make our slider toggle through percentages. So first thing you need to do is make sure that you have the developer tab. If you don't see the developer tab, just right click anywhere on your ribbon, select customize the ribbon. From the command dropdown, go to main tabs and then find developer. Then you'll want to click add and okay to add it to your ribbon. So to insert your slider, let's go to the developer tab and in the control section, click insert. And we're going to insert a scroll bar from the form control section. The scroll bar is actually what we often refer to as a slider. So we'll click on this and notice how your cursor changes to a plus sign. Well, when this happens, you can draw your slider anywhere on your sheet and use the corners to position it or resize it however we want to. And also a quick tip, if you press your Alt key as you draw your scroll bar, it will also snap it into a cell. Next, right-click on the slider and select Format Control. And these are the inputs that will drive your slider. So the current value we won't worry about. This will be whatever value the slider is displaying, so it's going to keep changing as the slider gets used. The minimum value refers to the minimum value that our slider will slide to, and we'll use 0 for this example. The maximum value I'm going to change to 100 because we're going to be making percents. The incremental change refers to the change in value each time that the center line is moved. And right now it's set to 1, so each time this is moved, it'll change 1%. The page change refers to the amount the value will change each time either of the end arrows is clicked. And 10 for 10% is fine for this. So the cell link will be a cell linked to the scroll bar, and it will display the value of the scroll bar. And because remember that our issue is these input fields are limited to only whole numbers, this linked cell will also only display whole numbers. We'll get around this by selecting a cell in an inconspicuous location and creating a reference to it where we actually want for the percentage to be displayed. So for this example, I don't want my end user to see it. So I'm going to place it in sheet 2 and then I'll hide this before finalizing my project. So on sheet 1, which for me is the one that my end users will see, I'm going to create a link to the cell that's connected to the slider. And then without leaving this other sheet, I'm going to divide this by 100 and make sure to format this as a percent. And now as we move the slider, we're able to toggle through percentage values. But what if you instead want your slider to also reflect a negative percent? Well, in that case, we need to make a small edit to the control values. Right-click on the slider, select Format Control, and we'll change the maximum value to 200. Click OK. And now here in the cell that's linked to the cell connected to the slider, we're going to use an if function. So we'll say if the slider reflects a value that's greater than or equal to 100, then we'll divide this by 100 and subtract 1, because remember that now our maximum value is 200. And then if it's less than 100, we're going to divide this number by 100 and make it negative. Oh, and let's not forget to hide sheet 2. Now, as we use the slider, we'll be able to toggle through negative percents at the top with the values increasing to positive percentages as we slide towards the bottom of the slider. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.